brooky drum, where was a garden to which came Jesus and his disciples. Judas also, who betrayed him, knew the place full well, for Jesus had often waited there to meet with his disciples. Now then, Judas, having gathered a body of men, whom the chief priests and the Pharisees had sent him, now cometh forth with torches, lanterns, and with weapons. Therefore Jesus, knowing all things that were to come upon him, went straightway forth and said to them, "Come seek him." And they answered him,
"Jesus!
Which betrayed him stood there among them. And as soon as Jesus had said, "'Tis I," all of them fell backward and fell to the ground. Then Jesus asked them a second time,
"Whom seek ye here?"
Again they answered,
"Jesus, Jesus, Jesus of Nazareth, Jesus of Nazareth, Jesus of Nazareth."
Jesus answered and said,
"I told you before, I am he. If ye seek for me, let these men go their way then."
Might be fulfilled which he had spoken, "I have not lost one disciple of them which thou gavest me." Then Simon Peter, having a sword, he drew it forth and struck at the high priest's serving man, and cut the man's right ear off, and this man was Malchus. Then said Jesus to Peter,
up thy sword in its scabbard. Shall I not drink the cup then? The cup my father hath given me to drink. The cup my father hath given me.
Thank you.
Also follow in Jesus' path, and another disciple. disciple to the high priest had long been known, and went with Peter within to the palace of the high priest. But without, at the doorway, Peter stood. Then did the other disciple, who was known to them in the palace, go out and spake unto her that tended the door, and brought also Peter within. Then saith the maid that tended the door to Peter, and the servants with them stood tending a fire of coals, for it was cold, and warmed themselves through. Peter also there among them stood warming himself. Then did the high priest turn and question Jesus of his disciples and of his doctrine. Thus then did Jesus reply,
I ever spake openly and freely to the world. Day after day before the school I did my teaching, and in the temple, where all the Jews always come together, and have said nothing in secret at all, why askest thou this of me? Rather ask of them who have heard my teaching what sort of thing it was I taught them. See now, they surely remember the whole of what I taught them.
But when Jesus thus had spoken, a manservant standing near to Jesus struck him with his open hand and said, dost thou dare unto the high priest thus to answer? Master, Jesus replied to him,
if 'twas evil I spake, bear thou witness to my evil words. But if I have spoken well, why smitest thou me?
Thank you.
Jesus bound, and then sent him bound to Caiaphas. Simon Peter stood still warming himself. Then said they unto him,
bewailing it bitterly.
led they Jesus up into the hall of judgment, and it was early, but they could themselves not enter, lest there they should be defiled, and thus might not eat the Passover. Then out went Pilate the judge unto them, and said,
What bring ye as a charge against this man accused?
Then they cried aloud and said unto him,
If this man were not a murderer,
from him.
art thou a king then?
Jesus answered him,
Thou sayest, I am a king then. To this end was I born, for this I am come here, that I bear witness to the truth. And all who seek the truth, they all will hear my voice.
Then said Pilate to him,
What is truth then?
And when he thus had spoken, he went out once again to the Jews and said unto them,
I find in him no fault at all, but ye have a custom at Passover that one man I should release you. Will you now that I take this king of the Jews and release him?
Then cried they together all again and shouted,
No, this man, no, him, no, no, not him.
And scared sore and bleeding, is part of heaven, is part of heaven above. Behold them, how each minute dies, so obscene, all bruised and bleeding, is part of heaven above.
Be strong.
sore and bleeding is part of heaven, is part of heaven above. Behold them, how each limit tries, succeed, all bruise and bleeding is part of heaven above.
Plated then for him a crown of thorns, and put it upon his head, and put on him a robe of purple. Oh, say,
thank you.
must take him hence and crucify him, for I find no fault in him at all.
The Jews straightway answered and said,
"We have a sacred law, and through grace and law he must pay. Thank you.
But the Jews cried out and shouted to Pilate,
"You now let this man go, then art thou no friend of sin.
You now let this man go, then art thou no friend of sin.
Let this man go, then art thou no friend of sin.
Is in the Hebrew tongue called Golgotha. For him an epigraph and put it upon the cross, and it was written, Jesus of Nazareth, the King of Judah. And this epigraph was read by many, for the town was not far from the place where Jesus was crucified. And the words were written in the Hebrew, the Latin, and the Grecian tongues. Then said the chief priests of the Jews unto Pilate,
I
soldiers. After thus they had crucified Jesus, divided all his garments in four equal portions, a portion for each of the soldiers there, and also his coat. Now the coat had no seam, but was woven from end to end. Was woven through and through. They said therefore one to another,
"Let us then not cut nor tear.
Disciple, see now, here be.
since Jesus knew full well that all was accomplished, as was written in the scripture, he said, I thirst. Now some vinegar stood in a vessel. They filled a sponge with vinegar from the vessel and put it upon a twig of hyssop and put it to his mouth to drink it. When the vinegar had touched the lips of Jesus, he said,
Judas, he rufes. Victorious Judas, he rufes. Victorious Judas, he rufes. And ends the strife, and ends the strife, and ends the strife.
Thank you.
and the world break and tremble, and the rocks burst asunder, and the caves were opened again, and many bodies of sleeping saints arose.
Oh,
this, therefore, because of the Passover, in order that the body should not remain on the cross for the Sabbath, for the Sabbath in that week was a high one. Now entreated Pilate to allow their legs to be broken, that they might from thence be taken. Then came the soldiers and brake the legs of the first one and the other which was crucified there with him. Then at last coming up to Jesus and perceiving that he had already died. Therefore they break not Jesus' legs, but one of the soldiers then took up his spear, and with his spear did he pierce his side, and straightway came the blood and water out. And he that hath seen these things, 'tis he who bear record, and his record is true. Nor indeed can he fail to know whereof he speaketh, that ye believe him. For all these things were done as promised by the Holy Scripture. The bone of him shall not be broken. Again in the Scripture another hath said, they shall behold him. Behold the one whom they have pierced.
Amen.
that gave unto him. Therefore came he thither and carried Jesus' body away. There came thither to Nicodemus, he who at first had come to Jesus in the night, and brought a mixture of myrrh and of aloes together, 100 pound weight. Then straightway took they Jesus' body, and wound it in the linen cloths with the myrrh and aloes, as the Jewish manner is to bury. Where the place was, where he was crucified, was a garden, and in the garden a new grave, in which no man yet had ever been laid. And therein then laid they Jesus, since it was the day of preparation, it being so.